When you hear Gs, 1G, 2G, 4G, 5G, the G is for generation. Every new technical evolution comes with an evolutionary change to the generation of that technology. 1G devices, that was all about wireless, being able to communicate without being in one specific location. 2G got us to digital standards. It got us off those old analog technologies and moved into the digital space. Then we got to the 3G space, and that's the first time we really saw texting and data and the ability to move information in ways we'd never been able to do so before. Now we could move it through our fingers. We could move information in different pathways, and the networks grew, and the usage of the networks grew, so much so that we needed to evolve again to support that capacity. That's when you saw 4G come into play. More users, more things being done on the network. It's also when you really saw high data come into play, and video. Once you brought video to play, you really had to expand the capacity of that network. And so now we see 5G networks coming into play. Really what 5G brings us is that ability to go faster, to go further. We want to have more capacity. We want to have more abilities in that network for all the consumers now that have computers in their pocket and use them all day long. One thing to know is that 5G is not all created equally. It's actually a conglomeration of lots of different frequency bands in order to get the experience that we want to see out of this advanced network. You're going to see low band frequencies. Those are frequencies that are heavily used in 4G networks today. They're great for being able to propagate a long distance. Those frequencies go through things like walls and windows fairly well to help balance some indoor and outdoor coverage needs. But they have some challenges too. They don't have the capacity that we want to see in our networks. So we weave in what we call mid-band spectrum. Mid-band spectrum's a little bit like Goldilocks. It has some great propagation capabilities, but maybe not as much as the low band, but the capacity comes up significantly. So you'll see this be the workhorse band of most of the 5G deployed across the country. And then all of the great benefits and the really fast speeds and the incredible capabilities that you hear about with 5G, a lot of that end of the spectrum falls in the high band spectrum. This is spectrum that can hold a tremendous amount of information, really give us a lot of capacity, but it doesn't propagate particularly well. So it takes a lot of infrastructure to build it out. You'll see those types of high-band spectrum capabilities deployed in areas like downtown cities, stadiums, where there's a huge amount of usage to support, but we need to be able to put that infrastructure in to get that network to operate correctly. So why is 5G going to be great for our first responder community? Well, one thing to know about the human brain is that we can process visual information about 60,000 times faster than we can process text. So in this case, a picture or a video is literally worth 60,000 words. And this 5G network is going to allow us to bring more of that video, more of that contextual data information, more of that situational awareness to our first responders. That's going to help them respond to emergencies and incidents and disasters far more effectively to keep them safer and to keep us as the community safer as well.